It's still the Breakfast Daily on City TV. Now, I've got exciting news for all Ghanaians out there because my GHP is back with a bang. Now, Ghana's biggest online payment and collections platform, my GHP, has been revamped with new additions to offer you a better and stronger online experience. With my GHP, you can make or receive payments online from any part of the world using a Visa or MasterCard, mobile money wallet, or bank account. To make your user experience even more exciting, we have introduced push notifications, in-app reporting, new services like data bundle purchases and box office subscriptions, GHQR payment options and security features like Face ID and fingerprint login. My GHP is Simply Pings. For business owners, now is the time to get on board and take your business global. Simply download My GHP from Play Store or App Store or visit www.myghp.com. Register by providing a few details and voila, you're ready to pay the easy way. Call us toll-free on 0800-124000 and let's get started. myghp.com. Buy, sell, connect. So that's some amazing news for those of us, or all of us, who want to do some online business transactions. Just register with myghpay.com and you are good to go. It's now time for the DIY or self-improvement segment. And today we're talking about our children. We're going to be speaking to a child growth and development enthusiast. He's also a tutor. And he is Michael Foley, and he's going to be giving us some insights on what to look out for when it comes to our children, of course, how to help them, nurture them, and watch or help them grow. Good morning, Michael.
Good morning. It's Thank good you to for have having you. Me.
Yeah, great. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling great.
Awesome. So let's start off nurturing the potential of our children. But I see that it says here you are a child growth and development enthusiast. Tell us a little bit about that briefly.
Good. Once again, good morning to all your cherished viewers out there. And thank you for the opportunity to be here. Talking about child growth and development is talking about the environment, the resources provided to children once they are born from infancy to ensure that they develop to their fullest potential. Life is in stages and growth is at all phases. But at our childhood, that's the formative years. And the actions that go on there go a long way to determine how we turn out later on in the future.
But let's look at the talents of children. At what age do you think they start exhibiting these talents, and how do we identify or spot these talents in order to nurture them?
Great. That's a very interesting question. I would say, depending on how observant you are, right from 18 months, you can tell your child's interest.
And when, 18 months?
Yes. When we are talking about talent, talent is not necessarily something someone can do.
Yeah.
It's basically what makes someone unique.
Right.
So when we talk about potential, potential is not something you put in. It's something the person came with. So once the person is on earth, if you're observant, if you look closely, you could tell what the person is interested in. So just broadening our horizon and understanding that children have something in them. No matter this, even before they start speaking, you could tell an interest of a child. So it's more about observation and knowing what you're looking out for. A child will be drawn to a particular color. A child could be drawn to a particular song, music, dancing. Not all children react to music the same way. Right from when they are moving around, they have started making facial expressions and all that, you could tell what they are enjoying and what they are not.
But you see, children have tend to behave in, for want of a better word, a funny way. I mean, they might be interested in something, but how do you tell if this is a talent or it's just a hobby?
Okay. Yeah. That's a good question. At that age, you need to provide the child a lot of opportunities to develop various interests. So as they continue to grow, they'll hold on to the one that they cherish more.
Right.
So if you develop that your child has a passion or penchant for sports, you need to channel that. At the same time, arts, you need to find ways of channeling that and growing that. So you don't limit the child to one area because they express interest in only that one area. You have to open opportunities for him or her, for them to discover what they love by themselves. As time is going on, a child may start developing interest in something. After some time, they just naturally let it go. So that's why as parents too, you don't have to be fixated on, I want my child to be this. Because when the child is resisting, you push, you push, you keep on pushing. And at the end of the day, the child will miss out on what he or she really wants to do.
Interesting. I like that. Now, for the child, talent to be fully nurtured, at least the child needs that confidence. So, I mean, there are several approaches, but what would be your approach to boosting the confidence of a child?
Beautiful. Right from infancy, there is something that really prevents children from being confident, and it's the trust that we don't have for them.
Right.
Unfortunately, most people, most human beings, feel that children in the next 1 minute will do something terrible. And so you always have to be on your guard with children. But it's really the wrong approach. Because with that, we have a lot of fears and anxieties around them. And at the end of the day, these fears and anxiety gets transferred to them. So I don't understand why human beings don't have confidence in their babies. For example, let's use this scenario. Like, let's say a fire has been set somewhere and there is a kitten around, okay? The human being will believe that the kitten will not run into the fire. But when there's a baby around, the human being just feels like the baby will just jump into the fire. so we tend to be...
Your mother instincts will actually kick in.
We tend to be overly protective. And at that stage where they are exploring, that's when they develop confidence. That's when they learn to trust the world. Because when they come, they don't believe in anything. That's why they don't even go to anybody apart from their mom. So putting those fears in them makes them distrustful of the world. So that's where the confidence is shattered in the beginning. So to develop a child's confidence, that's one of the main things we are supposed to do. Have confidence in them. Sometimes you just have to relax and watch what will happen. And most of the time, our selfishness doesn't help. Because many of us have children, but we want to live like we don't. So you have an environment that is dangerous, and every 1 minute you have to stop a child from doing something. So you need to consider the environment you have once you have children, and make sure that the environment is safe enough for them to explore any anywhere where they will not have trouble, even with your eyes not on them. So that you have considered a child, and that is going to make the child confident. That is going to bring the child out. The child is going to be confident to take enough risk. So, for example, if you leave your room, you come and you see your child 18 months on top of a table, one parent will just rush and then pick the child because, but you have to pause and ask yourself, how did he get there? Probably, let me watch and see how he will calm down. So all these things, I want to take it from the
root. But this will be after you have created a child-friendly environment.
So once you've created that environment, you should allow the child to grow and develop naturally. So the environment is very important. Another thing that will help children grow in confidence is, this might be surprising, but not giving them too much praise. This might be very surprising
because
to people.
Because they tend to do more when you praise them.
So. Exactly. That's what it looks like. But anytime you give, I'm not saying don't praise your child, but too much praise. Anytime you give too much praise to a child, the fulfillment leaves, the fulfillment in what he's doing is moved, and then the fulfillment now hangs on your praise.
So they feel the urge to do something else to get
more praise. Or anytime they do that and they don't get the praise, they feel like they've not done it well. So what you need to do, and you not always be there to praise your child. Your child may be good at something, and if all your child depends on his praise, when they meet mean people, do not be confident. Mommy is not here to praise me. So what you need to do is you need to encourage, not give too much praise. So your child does an artwork, you don't need to give the child too much praise. What you need to do, you need to show your child that I believe in you. So let's hang that artwork up there. And anytime you see it, you know that you are really good at this. You should be proud of yourself instead of saying, I'm so proud of you. Because you always want someone else to be proud of and not have confidence in himself.
So that's the confidence bit. Now there's the self-esteem bit. In what ways do we tend to hamper or limit the self-esteem of our children? And in what ways can we support and build their self-esteem?
Self-esteem, one thing we need to do with that is we need to ensure that our children know who they are. our children believe in themselves. One thing we need to be doing is we need to be speaking a lot to our children,
right.
Having conversation with them. And in our conversations, we should make sure that our conversations are building our children up. One thing, if a child understands who he is, where he's coming from and where he's going, I don't think anything can stop that child.
Right.
So not having that relationship will not allow the child to build that self-esteem. So you're a mom, you're a dad, you need to have conversations with your child. Let that child believe in himself. Let that child believe in his potential. Let that child believe in how beautiful he or she is. And let that child be aware that there are mean people out there.
Yeah, of course.
And definitely not everyone. People are going to make him or her feel bad, but just remember that they are great no matter what.
Yeah. So as parents, I mean, we have our dreams, we have our aspirations. Mm-hmm. Obviously, our children also do have fears.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, we have set targets or objectives that we want our children to achieve.
Mm-hmm.
So there usually is that conflict of what we want our children to be and what they themselves want to be.
Mm-hmm.
How do we find that middle ground in order to support the dreams of our children?
Okay. So this boils down to the fear of success or failure. That's what it really is.
Yeah.
So when you want your child to do something, most of the time it's because you feel like they'll succeed when they go there.
Mm-hmm.
And what do we define success as? That's what we have to ask ourselves.
Mm.
Most of the time, we use finances to determine success. And one thing we can do is that at an early stage, start teaching your child about money. When you start teaching your child about money, how to handle money, how to grow financially, your child can do anything and they'll be successful.
Right.
So that's where our education is. We don't prioritize it. We want to teach the child everything apart from money and believe that because they know all that we've taught them, they will be successful.
Yeah.
So we need to encourage financial wisdom and knowledge for our kids at a very early stage.
Right.
At an early stage, you need to start inculcating savings. Yeah. At an early stage, you need to start letting your child save towards getting what they really want. So all these things train the child. I'm taking it financially because I know that's the foundation for a lot of people pushing their children to particular areas. So when you have that foundation where the child is money-wise, is the child could succeed in any field, no matter what they find themselves doing. And then the issue about trust and confidence in them also comes up. And sometimes, you see, when we don't have confidence in them, we don't really see who they are at an early stage. So for example, you never knew your child is good at music because you don't have that relationship. Then all of a sudden they say they are going to music. You are going to kick back because you are going to have fears. But if you've seen how good they are in from childhood, there's no way you're going to. So most of us don't really know our children. That's the unfortunate side of it.
We should get to know our children. But let's look at the kind of conversations we should be having with them. Because our children tend to imagine a lot of things. I mean, their level of imagination is absolutely up there. So what kind of conversations should we be having with children in order not to kill their dreams when they tend to talk about their imaginations and all that?
Yes, that's great. One thing is that we should create room to be in the lives of our children. Many people want to have children and they want to make time for them. If you try to make time for your children, you frustrate yourself and you frustrate them. Rather, you have to live with them.
Okay.
So you need to involve your child in your life and be a part of theirs. What people do is that their children don't know anything about their lives and they try to just spend quality time with them, take them here, take them there, enroll them here, enroll them there. But children are actually interested in the adult world. They're interested in what you do. So if you watch and you observe a child playing, they are not children in their play. Most of the time, they are doing something that mommy does. They're doing something that daddy does. They're doing something that they've seen an adult doing. So in having your child aware about what you do or doing that, maybe you are preparing a meal. Whilst you are cooking, you are having a conversation with your child and they've joined you. So at that moment, the child is free to ask questions. The child is free to find out why this, why that. And in those conversations, it creates the natural atmosphere for your child to tell you about stuff.
Right.
But if you just go randomly to your child, how are you? I want us to talk about this. The child doesn't really feel that you're actually there for them. So let it be natural, let it be random, just being there for them. Mm. The conversations come in and then you talk about stuff naturally rather than out of the blue you show up. Mm. What's wrong with you? What if you have that natural relationship, you actually know what's going on in their lives without even asking.
Awesome, awesome. I want to dwell more on this and then find out the importance of engaging them in, say, current issues, issues that might interest you.
Good.
Is it important that we find a way to engage them on our issues so they get to learn about some of the current happenings around them? Like what we saw recently, the Green Ghana Project and all that issues of Galamsey and its impact on our water bodies. How important is it to engage them at that age while they grow?
Very, very important. Mm-hmm. Very, very important. And this is something that a lot of us fail to do because we feel like children do not understand this or this doesn't concern them. And coming back to the fact that allowing them into your life, assuming you were watching the news and that came up and your child is there, mommy, what is Green Ghana?
Yeah.
Then that provides the platform for you to talk about it. But if you just go out of the blue, let me tell you about Green Ghana, the child... You start 1 minute and the child is distracted.
Yeah.
So when they come with the questions, it provides the platform for you to give them something. So you should create the environment that will allow them to ask those questions. And then once they're in your environment, you definitely have, because they're inquisitive. Mm. So once they ask the questions, you get them to understand what's going on. You show a picture of a water body that is
being destroyed.
Right, you ask, mommy, what happened then? Yeah. You have the opportunity.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. Mike, do you have any children on your own?
No.
From the way you talk, you're going to have many. Careful you don't become an Abraham.
No.
All right, thank
I have
so
many
much.
That I'm working with already.
Thank you so much. Where can we find you on social media?
Teach with Mike on all social media platforms.
Awesome, awesome. Michael is a child growth and development enthusiast. It's been great talking to him about nurturing our children into becoming who they want to be.
Hi there. We hope you enjoyed the show.
Make sure to subscribe, like, comment, and share with your friends.
This is Breakfast Daily on City TV.
Join the Breakfast Daily team Monday through Fridays from 7:30 a.m. to 10. Join us for breakfast daily, only on City TV.